Davis Arena as the role model. As he usually does, his pre-match ritual says a quiet prayer, and he needs to. After the things he's done to other people, wait a minute. Randy Orton coming up from behind. He's not going to interrupt the prayer, but by God, he is going to get cooking right afterwards. And they're standing toe-to-toe already, and Randy Orton needs to tell Rico Constantino a thing or two. In this match, there's no seconds at ringside, no managers allowed. Kenny Bowen, Jerome Crony, Mr. Black, all the rest of them. Backflip from a dropkick. Nobody at ringside to help the role model. There's a lateral crash, count of two. And we have security watching the doors for any sign of a Bowen or his hired thugs.
Not to worry about keeping pretty much anyone out of here but Bowen. Randy Orton, this young man that does things on his own, he's out here by himself each and every week. It's Bowen out here that's causing all the problems all the time.
Well, we saw that last week in the footage. Bowen was all over the place like a cheap suit. Good analogy in my opinion. Rico with those knife-edge chops to the sternum. But boy, lots of big news already tonight. The Undertaker will appear at the Last Dance, the Garden, June 27th. Oh, big chop there. Mick Foley will be here on OVW TV next Saturday night, May the 5th. And for you folks in the area who would like to attend the taping and see Mick Foley live, that taping is this Thursday night, May 3rd, here at the Davis Arena in Jeffersonville, 8 p.m. bell time. Get here early for good seats. And folks, as we said earlier, when the Disciples of Sin gave their ultimatum, we will give the Minnesota Stretching Crew as much time as possible in tonight's show to recover from the attack by Smooth and Sly and defend their tag team championship. Randy Orton sets Rico on the apron. Now right hand. Now Randy Orton going to bring the role model in with a vertical suplex over the top, and Rico blocking him. Oh, wait, oh my God! Oh my God!
Oh.
He just hip-tossed Randy Orton over the top rope. That's not a throw over the top rope. Referee Robert Briscoe having to make a judgment call. You can't throw a man over the top rope from inside the ring when you're already outside. I've never seen that before. I don't know what the hell to do about that.
And, buddy, you talk about a throw here. I mean, you're coming off the top rope to the floor. You're talking 10, 11 feet drop here. And this young man, his face first on the concrete, your role model, Rico Constantino.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, man, not a very good role model for the kids
out there. Kidneys to the concrete post there. And now Rico taunting the folks here at the audience of Davis Arena. As Randy Orton, as you said, he felt, looked like he had first to try to get his arms out in front of him and break his fall, but that was a nasty, a very precarious fall, a dangerous situation. And Randy Orton, with all the guts in the world, he's struggling, trying to get back in, trying to fire back. But Rico cuts him off with a knee to the gut, vertical suplex. And as we have seen so many times, oh, wait a minute, lateral press there, count of two. As we have seen so many times from this young Randy Orton, which has led to his popularity and his tremendous winning streak over the past couple of months. Randy Orton has guts. Randy Orton has heart. Even though he's still a rookie, just barely turned 21 years old, he's a third-generation superstar. He grew up in this business. And I'll tell you one thing right now. He is not going to give up. He's not going to lay down and play dead. He's not going to roll over. Randy Orton, look at there. He got to the ropes, forcing Rico to break that chin lock. Randy Orton is a man that you will have to beat to get a victory over. Randy Orton is not a man that's going to take the easy way out or the cheap way out. Oh, big backdrop there, high elevation. And Randy once again down at the hands of the more experienced role model, Rico Constantino.
And you notice right there, if you caught what I just saw there, Rico glanced over at the ring apron as though he was looking for Bowen briefly. As though, you know, he's supposed to be there giving me some inspiration or whatever. He glanced over there and he was not there.
Now, look at this. That's a submission maneuver. The Boston Crab putting a tremendous pressure on the lower back. But let's get folks here in the Davis Arena. Go, Randy, go. Go, Randy, go. Urging and exhorting Randy Orton to be able to make the ropes.
Oh.
And he did. He got that rope. And that's calling Robert Briscoe to make the break. Rico frustrated there because he had all that pressure on Randy Orton's lower back. And Randy Orton being a youngster about 6'5", 6'6". Oh, wait a minute. A belly-to-back suplex with authority. One, two, no. Once again, Randy Orton fights his way up. And once again, the folks here in the Davis Arena firmly behind young Randy Orton. A hell of a chance at an upset win here over Rico if he could just stay in this ball game. And as we said, nobody at ringside to help Rico. It's one-on-one between these two men. Rico going for the choke, and he's throttling him. Look at that, right, a double-handed choke right in front of Briscoe.
And I'm telling you something to this. It's two or three times I've seen Constantino glance over into his corner. This is obviously bothering him just a little
bit. Oh, my God, did you see that? He boosted Orton up. He caught him over his shoulder and power slammed him in one motion. Randy Orton, a former hardcore champion at Flash, has said he'll give Orton another shot at the hardcore title as soon as Flash gets doctor's clearance on that injured elbow. Rico, oh, my God. Rico went for the swanton, and he narrowly missed him. offensive. He has to turn the tide here. And Randy Orton now stinging Rico. He's stinging him. And now he puts him down.
One big fist after another puts the room on his butt, sets him up for the right across the ring. Brings him down on that knee, buddy. Comes up, man, brings that fist right to the chin of Constantino, backs him up into the rope, they're right across the ring.
Man! Oh, a beautiful spinning sidewalk slam there, count of two and no. Rico Constantino just barely got up before the three count was told. Now Randy Orton sends his man to a high backdrop. Orton measures his man, there's a clothesline, he just knocked him silly. Now Orton hits the ropes, big leg drop across the chest. There's another lateral press. And once again, Rico still too strong, but Randy Orton has definitely changed the momentum of this match. There's Rico with a knee to the gut, and he nails him with the right hand. Going for the slam, Orton behind. He's got, wait a minute. He's going for the roll-up, and he got the roll-up, and he clipped Fresco. He's got that roll-up.
Three, that'll be it.
What the hell? What the hell is that? My God, oh my God. That woman just jumped in. What the? You've got to be out of your mind.
That's Bolin.
That is Teddy Bolin. He lost his wig. That's Bolin, the big fat bastard. He's dressed like a woman. He just hit Randy with that purse.
Oh, man.
Oh, I can't believe this. I cannot believe this. Oh, there's folks here in the Davis Arena just about to climb in the ring. Rico is getting out of here with his ill-gotten victory. Briscoe's got that purse had a brick in it. That purse had a stinking brick in it. Bolin dressed like a woman. He finally came out of the closet, and it was a big closet.